if that's not working, the control box is underneath. Underneath there. Get under there. That's it. Get in there. Now, there's some wires. Touch those two together. Cross the gap. Yeah, maybe... maybe it wasn't those two after all. Right, lab coat on. I'm ready for duty. You'll get better. Hello, I'm Richard Hammond. Welcome to my blast lab. We shall begin a series of complex scientific experiments with two teams of players competing using their massive scientific brains. In fact, the only thing that's thick in here is the walls. 3 meters thick, in fact, because sometimes my experiments are a little unreliable and dangerous. Let's have a look at what's in store today. Top secret underground lab is guarded by a team of 20 crack SAS professionals. They're trained in all forms of combat, they use the latest high-tech weaponry, and they're skilled in the art of invisibility, which is annoying because I can't find them anywhere. Not to worry though, I've drafted in the next best thing, my Nan. She can take on 20 people at once and she makes a really nice flan. She is my Ninja Nan. She may look fragile, but she is a fully trained ninja. See? Yeah, see? Nan, if you'd like to... oh, it's gone again. Nan! Nan! If you'd like to take your place and get settled into security, thank you very much. And there she goes! Look at her move! She's so fast. She only looks slow because we've actually had to film her in slow motion so you can see her, otherwise she's just a blur. Honest? Look at her go. It's further than you think, though. Ninja Nan, are you settled in yet? Are you in your places? No, don't worry about him. He had a bit of an accident. It was his own fault. Nan will get settled in. It's comforting to know she's there to guard us. OK, let's have a look at the people who are trying to get into my lab today. Show yourselves, please. Yes, yes, it's all very well getting excited. They say they're the yellow team. We don't know that. We can't let just anybody into the blast lab. We've got to be careful for security reasons. So, identify yourselves by names, please. Alex, Alex and Rory, yep, that checks out. Hidden talent, it's got your name here, Rory, and it says you play a musical instrument. I'm guessing it's what, the recorder, the banjo?
Trombone.
Oh, really? If you can play the trombone, I'll believe you are the yellow team. We'll let you through security. Oh, you see scales. Very technical. Not the most melodic listen, but I'd say they were accurate. Right, you can play the trombone. You are the yellow team. Come into the blast lab, please. Mind the lab rat. Yellows, welcome to the lab. Great to have you here. Sorry about the security checks. Mm. Can't be too careful. All sorts of people try and get in here. Where are you from?
Saturn! And we are the Nuclear Boys!
You went to the trouble of thinking of your own team name. Why? You're the yellow team and that's that. Now, we're about to meet the bunch of people who claim to be your opposition. Let's have a look at them. They say they're the red team, but we can't be sure. Let's have a look. Yeah. So-called red team. Now, we can't just let you in. Got to check that out first. Security checks. Identify yourselves by name, please.
Robbie! Emily! Charlotte!
Robbie, Emily and Charlotte. Yep, that checks out. Robbie, it's got your name here for the hidden talent. What are you going to do for us?
Count to 13 Spanish.
Go on, then.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis.
How far are you counting?
Well, to 30.
OK, carry on.
Siete, ocho, nueve.
How far have you got now?
10.
That's far enough. Right, you can speak Spanish. Come in. You are the red team. Hello, Reds. Great to have you in the Blast Lab. Thanks for coming along. Where have you come from?
Featherstone. And we are the Invincible Terrible Trio.
Great name, but useless. You're the red team, and that's that. But thanks for coming in. Right, Reds and Yellows, both teams, go and get settled in and comfortable because we're about to play round one. It's time to bring out my intelligent assistant. He's got a degree from Oxford and an MOT from Cambridge. It is Oliver. Latest state-of-the-art high-tech fact nav system, and it really wasn't very hard to do. to be honest. It was very, very hard to do, and as a result, it's not working quite as well as I'd planned. So a lot of the facts are not true. I need our two teams to tell us whether the facts I give them are true or false. If they are true, Oliver will do this. And if they're false, he'll let us know by doing this. So, simple enough rules, teams, and your first chance to earn points in the Blast Lab. Reds, you're going first. There are 300 bones in a child's body, but only 206 in an adult. Is that true or false? Audience, what do we think? Is that true or false? Kind of a mixed bag in the audience. Quite a few trues down here, but mostly false over there. What's your answer, Emmy?
It's false.
You think it's false?
Thank you.
You all agree on that?
Yeah.
OK. Oliver, is it true or false? It's true! Bad luck, so no point there for you. In actual fact, some of the bones in a child's body fuse together as they grow older, so that by the time they reach adulthood, the number of bones has reduced to 206. Right, yellow team, your science fact. Here it is. The Earth is completely round. True or false? Have a talk, have a think. Audience, is that true or false? What do we think? The majority of the audience saying true, actually. But, as always, be independent. What do we reckon?
False.
Okay, the yellows think that is false. Oliver, is it true or false? It is false. That's a point for the yellows straight away there. Well done. A little celebratory dance going on there from the yellow team. Well done, chaps. Actually, the Earth isn't completely round because when it spins like that, it bulges in the middle. That's a technical explanation for you. OK, right, the third question. How many seconds are in a year? Good luck, teams. Audience, what do we think? Anybody got any idea? Anybody got a clue? I'm going to come and talk to you using my new plant mic. That's not gone down as well as I'd hoped. You're not... Look, it's a microphone. You see? It's hidden in there. What's your name?
Jordan.
You see, Jordan, I only heard that because of the microphone. Hidden. I'm going to offer it to spies. OK. Anybody got any idea how many seconds there are in a year? Yes?
10 million.
10 million. OK, OK. Any advance on that? Hazard a guess or...?
Over 1,000 million.
Over 1,000 million. OK, we're getting some big numbers. Right. Reds, yellows. Turn your boards around. Let's have a look at what you've written down. Reds first. You've written 1 million. 1 million. Yellows have got 61,200. Well, the actual answer is 31,536,000 seconds in a year, which means the point clearly goes to Reds. Well done! Even though you were still quite a long way away, you were the closest, you get the point, which brings it to a draw. Actually, for the average chap, they'll live for 2,365,200,000 seconds. Right, that means points now, one all. But right now, it's time for mini-science, the round where our teams use ordinary household objects to conduct extraordinary scientific experiments. And for this, we need the help of my old-school science teacher, Mini-Miss! Sorry, miss. Sorry, I know I am a mess. I know, miss. If you are wondering, by the way, the secret of their youthful looks, that is me. I've made a time machine to bring her into the Blast Lab, and unfortunately, with the time machine, I made a few schoolboy errors. And as a result, she came out of it as a schoolgirl. Sorry, miss.
You never were the sharpest tool in the box, were you, Richard?
No, miss. No, miss. Sorry. So, what are we doing today?
Well, today we're looking at propulsion.
Brilliant! How?
Well, one team member from each team is stranded on the other side of the toxic tank.
Okay.
And it's up to the rest of the team members to rescue them using a balloon rocket.
Wow! So they're going to make balloon rockets to actually fly away with Alex and Robson on them. They're going to have to be really big. They're not doing that, are they, miss? Sorry, miss, what are they doing?
Well, the stranded teammate has to throw a ball attached to an emergency line across to the other two safe teammates. When they've caught it, they must tie the line to their side, blow up a balloon...
You're giving me this to blow up, aren't you, miss?
Yes.
OK.
Attach it to a straw and fix it onto the line.
Right, miss. These are not easy balloons to blow up, miss.
Now...
I feel a bit funny, miss.
The balloon...
I think I see what's going to happen here.
To the straw, using hook and loop fasteners.
So that goes on there like that. Is that right, miss?
Yes.
And that's their rocket.
When the balloon is let go, it should fly across the line to the other side.
That's fantastic. It actually works. All right. Well, this is a straight race, isn't it,
this one?
Because then when the balloon hits the other side, that's when flare goes off. That signifies rescue. It's all over.
Yes.
So it's a race to get there first.
Yes.
All right. I reckon, teams, before we start this, it's only fair to give you a little bit of practice at making your balloon rockets. Minimus, could you go and assist them in doing this? While they're doing that, here's a bit about the science that's going on. It's pretty simple. When the balloon is blown up, the rubber's all stretched, and it wants to shrink back into its original shape, and that squeezes the air out of this end. And that is where one of Blast Lab's all-time heroes comes into play. Sir Isaac Newton. Well, I say comes into play, he's not actually coming into the lab to do it, because he lived in the 1600s, but his ideas do. You see, Newton was very good at explaining things. At the time, a lot of people thought he was bonkers, but he's turned out later on to have been right about a lot of stuff. He came up with laws that described why things do what they do all around us. And today, we'll be using one of those laws, his third one. What he said was, in his third law, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Boil it down, and what that means actually is if you push this way, there's an equal and opposite push going on this way. Well, that's what's happening here. The balloon, when it's inflated like that, it slowly deflates, squirts the air that way, which means there's a push. So there's a push sending the balloon that way. You see? It's as though old Isaac Newton was here himself, helping our teams bring balloon rockets to fire across our toxic tank. Right, teams, how are we doing? Are we ready to start?
Yeah.
Good. If we all get into our starting positions, Alex Robson will be there to rescue you soon. Don't worry, hang on. This is a straight race then, and that race starts... Oh, I'd say now,
and they're off. Lots of activity, but who's in front? Yellow's concentrating hard there. The wires are going up. Blowing up their balloon already. Come on, Reds. Get busy. Oh, the Reds look like they're having problems as the Yellows put the finishing touches to their rocket. There it goes. A clear win for the Yellow team. Reds, what happened?
There we have it. Alex, you're saved by your teammates. I'm afraid, Robson, they just left you there, honestly. So that means a point straight away to the Yellow team. Bringing the scores to 2-1. Yeah. Now, propelling small straws across the toxic tank is all well and good, but could we use the same theory, Isaac Newton's third law, to propel something more exciting, like a man?
Here we see two of the worst examples of the human form on the planet, otherwise known as lab rats, indulging in what looks like some uncharacteristically impressive basketball skills. There's something not right here. Ah, I see. Pathetic. The lab rats managed to score with the hoop set at around 1.5 metres. Professional players can score with the hoop at 3 metres. I think we can do better. Much better. We're setting the hoop at a height of 30 metres from the ground to attempt the highest slam dunk the world has ever seen. Ever. This earth-shattering feat cannot be attempted by any ordinary man. We need a man who makes the impossible possible. We need a man who laughs at danger and kicks sand in the face of failure. We need...
Hello. I'm a jetpack man.
Really? You look like a lab rat with a moustache wearing a leather jacket and a silly hat. 2 fire extinguishers, that's original. Propel yourself into the air, drop the basketball and set a new record. That's never gonna work. Lab rats are completely useless and bred for this type of thing, so please don't feel sorry for them or actually do anything they do. 3, 2, 1, blast off! Ah. Okay then. Must have been those extra kippers he had for breakfast. We're going to have to beef this experiment up, I think. Time to call in the Americans. This all-American hero is one of only two rocket men in the world. No one is more experienced or confident.
I'm Jetpack Man.
But he's never tried anything like this. The Jetpack Man's canisters are filled with hydrogen peroxide. When it's mixed with certain metals, like silver, it turns into oxygen and superheated steam. This shoots downwards out of the bottom of the pack at almost supersonic speeds, which should launch the Rocket Man upwards and into the sky. Well, that's the theory anyway. Can American muscle succeed where British steely determination failed so miserably? One man against the odds, against gravity and against the doubters. The odds are stacked against him, as he only has enough fuel to stay airborne for about 30 seconds, so he's also racing against the clock. 3, 2, 1, blast off.
Okay, I think there's a point available here. Score right now, 2 to the yellows, 1 to the reds. There's another point up for grabs. You could equalise if you get this. And I'll give that point to the team who can correctly tell me, will Jetpack Man be able to slam dunk that basketball into the hoop? What do you think? Will he do it or not?
No.
You think not? Reds, will he do it or not?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, good. So there's a point difference here. Reds think he will, yellows think he won't. Let's find out.
So, this is it. He knows what he has to do. The time for talking is over. The time to fly is upon us. 3, 2, 1, blast off! There he goes, we have liftoff! Every second counts as he spins through the air trying to maneuver into position. He's closing in on the unsuspecting hoop. Steady, steady. He's done it! Amazing! I gotta testify. A perfect run there for the American Jetpack Man as he glides effortlessly up to 30 meters, spins right around the hoop and scoring on his first attempt. He's loving it. The lab rats love it. In fact, it seems there is only one person who doesn't share in their celebrations. Like a true hero, Jetpack Man waves goodbye to his adoring public before disappearing off into the horizon. Feels good to be home.
So there you go, the point goes to the red team, which equalizes the score at 2 each. And now we must move on towards the messy, messy mess test, which means you guys have all got to go off and get changed into protective outfits. You're gonna need them. Away you go. You go and get ready for that. Go and get ready for that. While they're getting ready, this is a treat for the rest of us audience. I'm delighted to say that Jetpack Man has come to join us in the lab. I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'm a test. Jetpack Man, Eric, how are you?
Nice to see you.
I think we can have another look at that bit of film because I want to watch you in action. You can talk us through what's going on. You're not going to take off now, are you?
No, I'll take my hands
off. Lab rats, please stop. Yes, that's the man's jetpack. Don't go near it. Don't let them touch that, will you? Let's have a look at the tape again. Let's have a look. So this is you in action right now. How does it? What does it feel like when it takes off first of all? There.
It's like jumping off the ground but not having to come back down.
But the really strange thing is here, you look like you're suspended from a wire. What are you doing to steer it there?
So the right handle is my throttle. That's for going up and down, and now I'm basically making a left turn, which would be this left hand that spins me. But to go forward, I just draw my hands down, so that's what's constantly driving me forward, and I can let up on them to slow it down, or and now I'm jockeying near the
So that
backboard.
Bit of maneuvering there was tricky.
That's definitely tricky.
I'm imagining this is the sort of thing that it's possible to make a quite amazing hash of.
Yeah, you're standing on top of 800 horsepower. It's basically the superheated steams at supersonic velocity.
800 horsepower?
Yeah.
That's as much as about five family cars, audience. That's an immense amount of power. How long does the fuel last?
It's got 33 seconds of fuel, Richard.
What happens then?
Then I get my sign out and help. I tell people I 911 God.
Yeah. Does it work like in the cartoons? That it just sort of coughs and sputters to a halt, and then your eyes go quite wide, and then you run for a bit in the air, and then you flap your... No, it doesn't. You just plummet to the ground.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, it's astonishing what you do. I think you're very brave. And I think you're now officially one of our Blast Lab heroes, because we are duly very impressed. You see, there's a lovely rosette. You're pleased with that, aren't you?
I love it. It's great.
Lab rats, get away from that. You're not allowed. This is a real live jetpack. Please, don't go near it. Boys and girls. Eric, jetpack man! You're very proud of that, I can tell.
Yes, that's great.
Right, time now for all of us to move on to the messy, messy mess test. Which today is the Gunge Bungee? Featuring, of course, my Blast Lab catapults. You don't want to know about the experiment I designed this for originally. Suffice it to say, the cats were not pleased. Today, though, we're going to use them for propelling prize pods across this tank of unspeakably toxic gunge. Here's the game. Teams, you've got to fire as many of these prize pods as you can across the tank and into the prize zone beyond. Winning team is the team to get the most prize pods into the prize zone, and you'll get to take home the prizes written on them. This being Blast Lab, though, there is, predictably, a twist. You'll notice a team player from each team in the gunge. These two players have two jobs. Firstly, you have to stop the opposing team's prize pods as they arc gracefully across the tank towards the prize zone. But at the same time, you've got to collect your own team's prize pods as they fall in the gunge, put them back into these baskets so that your teammates can fire them across into the prize zone. Oh, important note for you guys. Do not go past this tape. I dropped a plutonium rod in there late last night, and it sort of superheated the whole thing. Incredible heat coming off it. I actually tried to dig it out with a spade, but it melted the spade. So for your own safety, don't go beyond there. Right, everybody understand their jobs. Catchers, blockers, you understand your jobs. Okay, you have some time to get as many prize pods as you possibly can across the toxic tank, and that some time starts now.
And the air is thick with prize pods already. A huge shot from the yellows. Shame it was also hugely off target. The red team are letting no yellow pods pass them. The red prize pods are building up. It's not looking good for the yellows.
Some amazing play there from the red team's blocker. She's stopping just about any of the yellow pods getting through. Really, really good.
It is mayhem out there. The teams have some time left. How long is anyone's guess? Because my sometime clock never works. Both teams are screaming encouragement at each other. At least, I think it's encouragement.
Things getting a little tense amongst the yellow team's players there. It's a tense business with the toxic tank. Oh, yeah.
The prize zone is looking like a very red place to be right now.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, teams. Everybody stop. Everybody stop there. Some great play going on, some frustration amongst both teams, and some unbelievably good blocking from you. That was astonishing. Right, let's find out which team has won. Lab Rat over here. For the yellow team, how many do we have? 4, indicated with his little paw there. For the red team, how many do we have? 7, that means the red team are the winners! And are quite pleased about it, as we can tell. Let's find out exactly what you've won. Reds, you're going to be taking home one of each of these prizes. Ready, Nan? Each of you will be taking home 20 questions. An electronic project set. Uno flash game. A science magic set. Horrible science book. A glider set. And an X-twin jet. There you go, each of you taking those prizes home. Okay, now the slightly tricky bit. Yellows, here's the funny thing. These are the prizes You would have won. An electronic project set. An ex-twin jet.
Oh, lovely.
20 questions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And an MP3 player. Each of you taking that. But it's OK, yellow team, because instead of taking them home, you're going to blow them all up. It's time for B-Day Goes Back. Well, we have come to that moment in Blast Lab. Reds, how are you feeling?
Great.
Very happy.
I think so too. Well, congratulations on winning. Well played. And all of this lot coming home with you. Good, because over here are the yellows. How are you feeling?
Disappointed.
Yeah,
a bit bad.
Disappointed, bad. Good. Glad you came into Blast Lab. Sorry, team. What went wrong in that last game?
The catapult was too slippery to put the stuff
in. So you're criticising the tools. That's what you're doing. You say you came to Blast Lab and my carefully designed, specially built catapult let you down. OK. Well, never mind, because it's time. There is no putting this off, is there? I do like to get a lot of bang for my buck, and this next invention costs a lot of bucks, so it better give a pretty big bang. Well, I think it probably will. Be afraid, it's my exploding B-Day. Your prizes have been loaded in ready. Who's going to press the plunger?
All of us.
Share the blame. It's so much easier after the event that way. Step forward and lift the plunger into the firing position, please, yellow team. There you go. Don't push it yet. OK, here we go.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So today we learnt Newton's third law of motion. If you push something one way, you'll make something else go in the opposite direction. However, I don't suppose that Newton made this discovery the same way as we did, by doing slam dunks with jetpacks and firing balloon rockets over a tank full of toxic gunge. See you next time. Blast Lab was recorded in front of a live studio audience. Probably no lab rats were hurt too badly during filming. Probably.
Hey Dan, check out these great holiday snaps. There are families who've taken part in the CBBC show Gimme a Break.
Oh yeah, where the kids take control of their family holiday, making it a lot more fun.
And if you'd like to do the same, then listen up, because we're looking for families to take part in the next series of Gimme a Break.
To apply, simply log on to our website, click on Be on a Show, then fill in the application form. Easy, AJ.
MI High is back, but which agents are returning? New term, new team, new rules. All new MI High, Monday at 5:15 on the CBBC channel.
We've got a new tastic, new fest and new stuff on CBBC.
Are you ready for your first mission?
Yeah! They're super newness.
13 superheroes begin the journey of a lifetime.
The best thing that's ever happened to me.
Noisy newness.
Hi, little Howard, I've come up with another of my big questions.
What are you doing?
I'm throwing off clothes on the roof.
Spooky newness.
It's a ghost.
No one's ever going to believe us, are they?
And really strange newness.
I'm Prince Dick.
I'm Prince Dom.
The Dancing Dolphins of Doom.
Are we done yet?
Get the whole shiny package of brand spanking new fun coming to CBBC in January. It's the place to be.
We're on a mission to provide the world with the next great superhero.